Thank you.
I didn't know if that was officially the end of the first song or not. So we always have people, when we don't talk, asking, is this the right show? Do I have the right station? So now would be a good time, since we're probably not going to talk again until 10:30, to go ahead and tell everybody who is just tuning in what you're listening to. This is WEFT Champagne, our legal ID. And our band tonight is Snail with a Y. Snail.
That is correct.
So how can people find your music online?
Facebook, Spotify, iTunes, Amazon, Bandcamp, SoundCloud, I got it all.
And would you mind introducing yourself and your bandmates tonight?
Hi, my name is Austin Duncan. I am Snail, usually a solo project, but I've been trying to incorporate more analog into the electronic, so to speak. So I've got my band here with me, tentatively being called Gastropod. Over here, Kelsey Sharp on keys. We just so happen to share a birthday, which just so happens to be today, and it's also our 3-year anniversary, so that's pretty cool.
Now, I would tell people who are listening but not watching that you probably have the most interesting dress style or fashion sense of anybody we've had. I mean, on the one hand, you're dressed super formally. On the other hand, everything is untucked, and but, you know, neckties... Really Party nice hats. Shoes, really nice, well, those of you, a lot of you are in socks, but they're nice socks, so. So yeah, on the one hand, it's like the most formal we've had, but on the other hand, there's a casualness that exceeds. So
one of the many faces of snails, so to speak.
And it goes with the lava lamp and the your friend there and the crystal, a crystal snail. So yeah, I'm sorry people can't, it really is, it looks kind of like a scene out of a 60s crime drama where they wander into some friendly pad for a hot tip or something. So speaking of hot tips, you have a show coming up May 31st, and both bands have been in touch about that, or two of the bands. I don't know if there's more than two, but...
I think there is three bands.
Okay, well, I've heard from two of them, so let's start with you.
Hi. Yeah, super stoked about that one. I was actually contacted by the out-of-town band. I was recommended by somebody, I'm not sure, but this will be my second time playing at Exile in the last month, so I'm super excited. I love playing there.
And I'm assuming that's a free show since it's at Exile, right?
Correct.
So everybody can... And what time is it?
I don't know.
Probably early.
Check the website.
So who are the other two bands?
Sinnet and King of the Coast.
I was hoping they all three started with S. I thought it was like a theme package or something.
No, I'm sorry.
All right. Well, we'll be hearing more about Sinnet in the 11 o'clock hour because I'm supposed to finally have some music of theirs to play. And... we're hearing you all hour, so unless you have anything else you want to go ahead and get to, I think we should turn it back over to you so you can do about 20 minutes of music uninterrupted.
Sure. I guess I've got a couple shows coming up between now and
then. Oh, mention those too. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. Okay, so April 10th, I'm playing at Vintage Villains in Danville, and then April 26th, there's the Death to the Accord, which is happening at the Accord. It's the final two shows going on there because they're closing.
All right.
Yes, the first night is free. That is going to be April 26th.
Wow.
It's going to be cool. We're going to be playing with CJ Run and ZXO.
So the venue in Danville is called what?
Vintage Villains.
Okay.
It's like a comic book store and stuff.
It's a really cool place.
I think I've been there, and long time ago. And the nights at the Accord are the 26th and the 27th, you said?
26th and the 28th.
26th and the 28th. And then that's going to become some other kind of club, right?
Yes, Rod Sigler is teaming up with the CMT crew to open some sort of new establishment, or supposedly.
Yeah, yet to be confirmed.
So they're not demolishing the building, but it won't be the Accord anymore.
Right.
Okay, well, unless you have anything else, I don't want to impede. So.
That's it for now.
All right, sounds good. Just keep it up.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hi, this is Snails speaking through the airwaves. That first song was Hungry Spirits, and that last song was Windy City. You can only guess what that's about. This next song is called Boreas, and it's the god of the northern winds. Thank you. That was Boreas, which is the god of the northern winds. All right, so we're about to switch it up, and we're going to do the full band now, as opposed to just me singular. So prep your ear holes, everybody. Thank you. That song was called Broken Clouds off of my second EP, which is still free to download, but if you choose to pay money, all of that money will go towards local organization Races, which is in desperate need of funding, and you should fund them. And also check out the music. I've got three songs left, including this one.
I was just thinking you segued into something that I said last week, which is when times are tight and it's harder to give, it seems like it hits organizations the same as it hits other people. So it sounds like Races and WEFT are both worthy causes that are maybe struggling right now. I actually just got an email asking if I could promote a like a Kickstarter or a Patreon or for a very worthy cause. And I said, well, unfortunately, that's the full schedule tonight. So, but I will point out the commonality of, you know, if somebody is the little guy from Monopoly, Rich Uncle Pennybags, and is looking for good causes, I have a long laundry list of them. So
please list some right here, right now.
Well, WEFT being the biggest, because we do we have staff now, and we want to keep staff, which means not just keeping the lights on, but also keeping them fed. And I think clothed is taken care of at this point, but...
it's kind of essential.
We're all pretty passionate driven here, but we do all still need to eat, so, and this is mostly volunteerism, so.
And also the best radio station around.
Oh, well, thank
Amen.
You. You can just come on every week and say that and play for an hour.
We will.
So I don't want to get too far. I did the WEFT legal ID, WEFT champagne. We're supposed to do that as close to 10:30 as possible, and with that out of the way, really... whatever we're talking about should be what you want to talk about. So we can talk as long as you want to, and then we can get back into the music. I like that you're at least offering your bandmates the opportunity. I always feel bad when people don't talk unless I find out they're shy and just don't want to, but I like them to have the opportunity.
We're all pretty shy.
But is there anything you want to know about us?
Is that where Snail comes from? Because it would make sense.
Okay, so the Snail comes from... when I first started making music off of a basically jacked music program for free, it all sounded like just really terrible Crash Bandicoot music. And it was just so slow. Everything, nothing was above like 50 BPM. And my old roommate Gabe described it as a snail trudging through garbage. And so I stuck with it, and this is Snail today.
Yeah, the fascinating thing is that's very similar to how Butch Vig named Garbage.
Really?
It was technically Butch Vig, Steve Marker, and Duke Erickson, I think. No Shirley Manson yet. And they were looking to do some drastic remixes where you couldn't even tell what it started out as. And they were told it just sounded like a bunch of garbage, and they decided they would...
well, it is garbage, huh? You know?
Like, then they...
we are garbage.
And apparently the first audition with Shirley Manson, they were like, we're never speaking again. But they had a second audition, and they've been active pretty much ever since. So you guys took a similar assessment and decided to run with it.
Essentially, yeah. It was me running solo. I released my first thing in, like, July of 2015.
Mm-hmm.
June of 2016, I released my first full-length album.
Wow.
Both of which self-released, and the second EP. Since releasing that first EP, I've played with L1011, Robert DeLong, Dixon's Violin, The Psychic Ills, and several others, as well as the Pygmalion Festival.
You just
last
named
year.
Off all my mom's favorite bands.
Oh, wow. Hey.
And I was going to say you really hit the ground running, but then I thought about a snail, and that's not really inappropriate.
Hit the ground sliding.
Slimy.
There we go. So, gosh, anything else you have at the shows? Will you have T-shirts? Will you have cassettes? Will you
I don't have
neckties?
Any T-shirts at the moment.
CDs.
I've got a few CDs. Those are running out quickly, though. I got about 6 copies left. Yeah, so very limited edition for the first pressing.
Normally, I would say we'd like a copy, but if you are selling them...
I have copies right there, and please take all of them if you need.
If you can sell them, though, I don't want to take money out of your pocket.
Please.
Remember, we're if you're sure...
Just take it.
Okay.
Please.
Less work, I guess.
Listen to it. Play it on the airwaves.
Yes. Coming up next week. And are the song titles tonight, do they correspond to this at all?
Hungry Spirits is the only one on that album.
Okay.
All new music.
Yeah.
Well, I'm excited to have an official copy. And I think we should let you get to those. Because we're not going to have copies of those songs unless you play them tonight.
True.
Do you have another one coming out soon?
I'm currently in the works of my second full-length album,
wow,
which is going to be featuring collaborations with Evan Opitz of the Phantom Broadcast.
Oh, yeah.
And he was in Marathon as well.
Seen a bunch of stuff.
Truth from Mother Nature,
mm-hmm,
Campaign Trillions, and Cela Cole from Mother Nature as well.
I have just one request. You said you have three left?
Yes.
So after two more, please make it very clear to me that I should come out and talk, because if I don't announce what's coming up, then it'll be hard to go straight from this show into the next show without dead air. So
I'll shriek like a banshee and give you some noodle arms.
I think that sounds very artistic. Make it part of a song, even.
Snail style.
All right, you're listening to Snail with a Y on Web Sessions on WEFT Champaign. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's the end of that song. Thank you, everybody, for the mandatory applause. That song doesn't have a name yet, and neither. Well, its nickname for right now is called Cowboy Gizzard, but I don't like it at all. So this next one is called Warm Rain. So I hope y'all enjoy. Thank you. Song left.
One, okay.
Yeah. Sorry, I so wrapped up in the moment.
Okay, so you did two and you have one to go.
Yes.
Okay, that is what I thought. I knew you couldn't have done all three unless you did some weird studio trickery there. So that I loved getting lost in that. It sounded wonderful.
Thank you very much.
I am sort of sorry that that one ended, but I guess we couldn't get to the next one unless it eventually ended.
So true. So true.
So we should tell people you're Snail with a Y, because as I found a few months ago, I can name a band every 60 seconds, but somebody will tune in after I've named them 55 times and ask, who's this? It sounds good. It
happens to me every time.
And I would rather people want to know after I've already identified them than not be interested. So, you know, your bigger problem is if people don't care. If they are wanting to check out something and support it, that's almost never a problem. So, yeah.
Hopefully they do care.
Just like if they want to donate to a cause, the issue is not, the issue is getting to that point. Once you're at that point, it's all gravy.
And as I understand it, you're in the middle of a pledge drive right now, right?
I understand Weft is in the middle of a pledge drive.
Holy
you're
cow.
Trying to fund some project. Your
Weft is
band
very
on your...
important.
Well, you know, that's probably a good opportunity to mention that if people haven't listened to WEF for a long time, they might not know. We used to get a large share of our funding from the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, and the Corporation for Public Broadcasting is not even doing that anymore. So they told us all the reasons that we no longer qualify, and then they said, but even if you did, we wouldn't be giving you money because we don't do that. So they told us all these things we could do that we would have requalified, but yeah, it's it's kind of pointless since they're not giving anybody money for that. So community radio is...
it's a darn shame.
Well, radio is historically important and interesting, but it's not a growing field, per se. And the surviving community radio station... Blah, 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 maybe we're not surviving because nobody can pronounce it. I don't know what came over me there, but the surviving community radio stations have to adapt to the fact that 51% of music sales now are streaming. So it's not even downloads. It's and what's scary to me is, you know, people talk about their favorite songs, but you're just renting them. You know, if they get yanked for any reason, you can't just go back and get them. There are no backups. So that's why I like vinyl, why I like CDs, because you have purchased the right to listen to that even if somebody changes his mind.
Definitely.
So, you know, cloud is great, but it's also nice to have something you can hold on to.
I really love getting my hands on a physical copy of something. Nothing feels quite as right. You know what I mean? I don't get the same satisfaction out of downloading something as I do, you know, going home, pulling that vinyl out of the sleeve and just like...
And it's not pixelated.
Right.
So, great, you know, great things about the internet and technology. Different things. I keep seeing smiles and wondering if, you know, we just got a big donor walking in or something.
HR money bags walking through the door over here.
Studio audience is good, too. So we should plug your shows again before the show is over.
Sure thing. Playing April 10th at Vintage Villains in Danville. And I am going to be playing April 26th at Death to the Accord, one of the final two Accord shows here in Champaign. Also May 5th, I am setting up the 5th Expressions event, which is an ongoing multimedia showcase that I do, which started out as a kind of a way for psychedelic and like a more experimental artist to express themselves as a means of like combating depression and stuff.
Oh.
So that was how that first got started. This will be the 5th installment of that. And then May 19th, I will be performing with the Autocorrect here in town.
What venue?
To be determined.
Ah. Well, you know, if you guys are still around, maybe at some point in the next hour, could you maybe mention a little more about your project you're talking about with the combating depression? Because
sure.
I feel like we might reach a different audience that hour, and I do want to get through your set, but that sounds interesting, and next hour there won't be any pressure to, you know,
absolutely
hurry. So, also, I will have no trouble remembering your April 10th date, because we talked about Garbage and Snail having things in common, and the Garbage song that I play the most on Weft is called April 10th.
Awesome.
Whoa.
So, unfortunately, I have no way to get to Danville, but...
my third eye has been ripped wide
yes,
open.
Yes, yes. I have also played a song called The Third Eye by the Dovers.
Even further.
Yeah.
Spreading.
Even layers upon layers. So, oh, and somebody apparently really did... take that literally, that those were my mom's favorite bands, which, you know, I mean, my mom's cool anyway, but I don't think she's had the access to those specific bands.
Not
so.
Yet. You give her a laptop, show her how to use it, and
yeah.
She'll be good to go.
That's the advantage of digital. So so hopefully we'll have you back. Any of you who want to talk the next hour when Andrew's in, and we can talk about worthy causes, But for now, it's Weft Sessions. You have one more song, and then I would say, everybody who has enjoyed this hour, please stay tuned. I'm going to follow this with something I think goes well with it, Lanterna. They're both pretty and atmospheric. Other local music, and talk about Pledge Drive, and then over 2 hours of music from 1962 to cap off the night. So
wonderful.
So, yeah, thanks, guys. Thanks to all four of you, but also your studio audience. And, yeah, one more song coming up from Snail. This is Snail, and I'm Todd, but they're Snail, and this is Weft Sessions on WEFT Champaign. We do this every Monday night with a different band, so 2 hours of local music every Monday night. Thanks for listening.
This song is tentatively called Stranger Things. And that's all we got.